Welcome back to the Property Show. Now, India is the perfect test case to set up a rental housing scheme on a mass scale, given the shortage of low-cost housing projects. But while the developed world has successfully implemented rental housing to cater to the segment for whom property buying is out of budget, India is yet to find success in rental housing. Nikhil Narayan Shivdas finds out why.
Talk to any average home buyer in Mumbai and it's clear that buying a home is simply not an option. With home prices skyrocketing, renting is the only choice left. And this is fast becoming the norm in other major cities. But why is there so little focus on creating rental housing stock by both the government and the private sector?
In India, you get yields between 2 to 4%. However, your capital appreciation on the real estate investment is 10%. So basically, whether it is Mumbai or Pan India, it actually does not make business sense for the investors to get into this sort of a business initiative.
This causes a problem, especially when you consider that rental accommodation is a cheap and effective option for large metros which have a huge floating population. That's not all. Experts say enabling rental housing is also a practical way for the government to reach its goal of housing for all.
Now we have a shortage of 2 to 3 crores in the big urban centers of India, 2 to 3 crore housing units. I do not think it's practically viable to construct all these units and offer them on ownership basis. It's just practically impossible.
Globally, countries like Canada, the USA and certain European nations have clear-cut policies and financial incentives for rental housing schemes, which have proved to be a big success. In contrast, the few attempts by government agencies in India have not done very well. Experts are calling for the government to formulate compelling financial incentives to get private developers interested in rental housing.
It could have something like, allowance of REITs to hold real estate assets of rental housing. It could be something like allowing a minimum benchmark or a minimum threshold. People who actually buy, it could also have a mechanism like rent to own, where people could initially rent, they could partake a mortgage or a housing loan, and then eventually buy.
Experts are also calling for a revamp of the country's Rent Control Acts, a move that will help property owners in the vast informal rental housing segment become formalized and reassure private players who feel that current laws are too one-sided in favor of the tenant.
Whenever there is a structured approach that is brought in by the government, it has a cascading impact on the private players itself. I think one of the things that will happen in rental housing is that we will have an international player coming in into rental housing who have done projects of rental housing, say whether in the US, Europe or Middle East, because they will have a good understanding of how the overall financials and the preferences of the consumers work.
The good news here is that the government is considering implementing a national rental housing policy. Now, if this goes through as planned, then soon you will see rental housing schemes transform the very nature of Indian real estate. From Mumbai, Nikhil Narayan Shivdas, NDTV.
Okay, moving on to our Q&As, we have Harish Bhai Trivedi with us. Hi Harish, where do you want to invest?
Yeah, I want to invest in Unique Vista project at Manpara.
Okay. And your budget is?
My budget is somewhere around 90 lakhs.
Okay, Thane, Manpara, Unique Vista project, 90 lakhs.
The project by Unique Vista, the Unique Shanti Developers, is a project that you can easily go ahead with it. It's 7,750 rupees a square foot. Although the developer has applied for a CC in terms of commencement certificate for revised drawings because he changed his drawings. But if you look at the weighted average price scale of the market, it's about 10,450 rupees a square foot. So it's very underpriced compared to that. And 28 months of the inventory overhang of this market depict that the sales are going to be a little slower, but still not that bad because Mumbai, Thane and Navi Mumbai, some micro markets inventory overhang has shot up by 40 months also. The price appreciation has been about 12-odd%. And the other two projects that you can consider are Acme Ozone by Alpinia. by Acme Group. This is between 9,500 and 9,800 rupees a square foot. It's located 3 kilometers from the Eastern Expressway and 9 kilometers from Mulund West. In the 2 kilometer radius, project around surrounded by social infrastructure, D-Mart, R-Mall, Holy Trinity, Trinity School are all there. It's located in Manpada, 500 meters of the Gurbandar Road. Raj Tourist by Rajesh Lifescapes, 9,100 rupees. Comes with 5 wings of G plus 25 stories. It's initial stages of construction. Connectivity of the project is very good, located 3 kilometers from the Eastern Expressway, which connects it directly with Mumbai, and 6 kilometers from the Thane railway station.
Okay, Harish, so the Unique Vistas project could be a bit of a wait given that you're still awaiting the developers awaiting the commencement certificate. So meanwhile, you can look at 2 more projects in Manpada, Acme Ozone Alpinia by Acme Group and Raj Tourist by Rajesh Life Spaces. Okay, moving on to an email by Rajesh Verma. He writes, I want to buy 2 BHK in Vasai, though I have invested in Veena Dynasty in Vasai East and Rajhans Shitij in Vasai West. My budget is 40 to 45 lakhs.
Well, from our point of view, both the projects get a go-ahead. Let's go one by one. Veena Dynasty Phase 2 is a project. It's a big development of 25-watt towers with G plus 7 stories, trading at around 5,000 rupees a square foot. Located in Vasai East, 200 meters away from the Vasai Link Road. Amenities are very good, including an amphitheater, senior citizen park, a multi-purpose sports area, and a 1.25 kilometer jogging track. Phase 1 with 14 towers is already ready and occupied too. The second project is going to be out of your budget, but still very good. Rajhans Kshitij Phase 2 by Rajhans Group at 5650 Vasai West. This consists of 4 blocks with a total of 17 towers. It's located 2.5 kilometers from the Vasai railway station and 300 meters off the Vasai station road. The data points of this micro market, Vasai East is about 27 months of inventory overhang and Vasai West is about 20 months. Weighted average price scale, West is more expensive, likewise in many other micro markets in Mumbai, 5100 rupees, whereas Vasai East is at 4900 rupees. Although Vasai West is more expensive, it's appreciated a lot more at 11% on an annualized basis, followed by Vasai East is about 7.2. The other last option that you can look at is Rashmi Classic by Rashmi Housing at 5000. This project consists of 11 wings of G plus 7 stories. Amenities include a central garden and kids play area, so not many amenities. There will be shops on the ground floor, if you can want to call that an amenity, although 1 kilometer from D-Mart, this project already is.
Okay, now we'll move on to Pune. We have Callistus Raskina with a question. Hi, Callistus. How can we help you?
Hello, ma'am, and hello, sir. Firstly, I would like to say your show is very, very, useful. And my question is actually, I wanted to invest around 1 crore in Pune, in eastern side of Pune. So what would be, the best, project? And I have really liked Clover Forest County in Kharadi. So should I go for that? And my requirement is 2 or 3 BHK that way.
Okay, Callistus, we have some other markets lined up for you and other projects recommended. Sameer, go ahead.
Yeah, we would like you to consider Hadapsar as a micro market, which is a self-contained mini city in itself, especially the Magarpatta township, which is the most famous township probably in India with a walk-to-work culture, has really emerged and made Hadapsar a key micro market from an India point of view. 27 months of inventory overhang, so sales in Pune have also slowed down and have started, the city has started to get affected. Weighted average price of the mid-segment is about 6,000 rupees and the price appreciation is about 11-odd%. Altorios by Akshar Developer is the first recommendation at 5,750 rupees a square foot. Spread across 4 acres, construction in various stages. Amenities like banquet hall, podium garden, jogging track, gym, library, study room, swimming pool, etc. Amanora Future Tower by Citigroup between 5,700 and 6,100 rupees. Is over 400 acres of integrated township, modern amenities like 1.6 lakh square feet of clubhouse, hospital, fire station, you can name the amenities in here, and it's one of the most awarded townships in the country with 61 prestigious awards. Urban Balance by VTP Group in Hadapsar at 5750, spread across 2 acres, this is a much smaller project. It's only 1 kilometer away from the Pune station, and amenities include amphitheater, swimming pool, clubhouse, multi-purpose hall, and developers have developed urban nirvana and urban space in Pune as well.
Okay, Callistus, so look at Harapsar, proximity to IT hubs in this location, very good livability, connectivity, and of course, presence of malls, schools, hospitals, and IT hubs. So a great market and strong growth drivers there. The projects you could look at in Harapsar, Altorios by Akshar Developers, Amanora Future Tower by City Group, and Urban Balance by VTP Group. And that is all the time we have for this edition of The Property Show. We'll be back soon with a new list of projects, locations, and buzzing industry trends to talk about. Until then, Sameer and I will take your leave. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.